Okay, give me just a minute. Boiling like this for a little while. I'm sure we're over temp, but I wanted to make sure we had a good batch, see what we're at. They say you have syrup at 219, and I'm sure I'm well over. Mentioned in a previous video, I always use a pan to can in, because I actually had a quart of maple syrup crack on us a couple years ago, and that was a mess I never want to have again. Alright. Better. Turn this off now. we're there. Alright, I'm going to turn this down just so we maintain heat while we're jarring this up. Alright, I'm going to turn that off. What I call liquid gold. Water so it sanitizes. Alright, I'm going to turn this back on. I don't want to lose too much heat. Already starting to bubble, so we didn't lose much. Oh, come on. bubbling again already. I'm going to turn it off. I don't want to heat it up too much. The more you heat it up and cool it, it creates more sand. Don't want to do that. Gentle. Oh. All right, three more. Definitely for us, we're keeping some. I'm using one of my older jars. Last little bit, I'm going to add to my jar of sugar sand that I'm saving. So this is the sand that I have, and I think I'm going to add that to this, and I'll use that. I'm going to do a batch of maple sugar again this year. Is kind of chilled, so I am going to go slow. I do not want to break my jar. Oh. worried about getting any more sand, obviously, because I'm going to turn this into sugar. We'll keep this in the fridge till we're completely done this season. And then I'll probably take all the sand that I collect along with probably another full pint of finished syrup, and I will turn that into sugar. So here we are. We have 7 finished pints. So I can turn that off now. So just like our last batch, we're 1 pint away from a full gallon. So it's a little bit darker than our first batch, but it still tastes delicious. Maybe in a few weeks the weather will warm up and we'll have another run. But for now we've got 2 pretty good batches.